we were discussing from second chapter, and yesterday we did till 57th shloka. So today we'll do 58. So this section is about the answers of Arjuna's question about the sthit prajna person, a person who is a sthit prajna, that means determined, fixed in Krishna consciousness, in buddhi yoga, or you can say in the samadhi. Okay, one second. Okay, so Arjuna basically asked a few questions, like we have discussed general symptoms, how does he speak, how does he walk, how does he sit. That was the his questions. How do, general symptoms was described in 2.55, 56 and 57 talk about the how does he speak. And now answer of the third question, which is how does he sit, who? A person who is in samadhi. Okay, so that means the question is about how does a person who is in samadhi, who is fixed in Krishna consciousness, how does that person restrains his senses and mentality? That's the point here. Okay, one second. Okay, okay, so okay, so we'll read the purport. ओके यदा संवरते चायं कूर्मो अंगानीव सर्वशः इंद्रियाणि अर्थेभ्यस्तस्य तस्य प्रज्ञा प्रतिष्ठिता. कृष्ण सेइंग वन हु इज एबल टू विथड्रॉ हिज सेंसेस फ्रॉम सेंस एज द टॉर्टोइज ड्रॉज इट्स लिम्स विद इन द शेल इज परफेक्ट कॉन्शियसनेस. सो हाउ डज ही सिट? That question implies sthit prajna person, a devotee of Krishna, how he is situated or how he has controlled his mentality and how he restrains from sense engagement, like that. Okay, so Krishna is giving the analogy of a tortoise. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. The test of a yogi or a devotee or a self-realized soul is that he is able to control the senses according to his plan. Whenever he want, he will control the senses. Whenever he want to engage them in the service of Krishna, he is able to do that. So most people, however, are servants of the senses and are thus directed by the dictation of the senses. Many of the people, they just serve their senses. Whatever senses desire, they just do it. Okay. So even somebody want to eat something, he'll just eat. Somebody want to do anything, or they want to watch something, they want to hear something, they just do it. Because senses demand and they fulfill their demand. They do not check, they do not distinguish what is needed, what is not needed. They just go on. They don't use their intelligence, their discrimination power. Okay, so they just serve the senses. That is the answer to the question as to how he is situated. The senses are compared to venomous serpents. devotee should be active in controlling the senses. How it is? Like a snake charmer. Okay, because senses are like venomous serpents. He never allows them to act independently. There are many injunctions in the revealed scripture. Some of them are do nots, don'ts, and some do's. Unless one is able to follow the do's and the don'ts, restricting oneself from sense enjoyment, it is not possible to be firmly fixed in Krishna consciousness. So if one is not able to follow do's and don'ts, because many people say there are so many rules, don't do this, don't do this. They are very much, ISKCON people are too much fixed in their rules. They have so many rules. So if one person is not able to follow do's and don'ts, he can. So we have to follow those do's and don'ts. Then only we will be able to progress in bhakti and we will be fixed in Krishna consciousness. So the best example here Krishna is giving is tortoise. The tortoise can at any moment wind up its senses and exhibit them again at any time for particular purposes. That's the quality, that's the characteristics of a tortoise, that he, whenever there is attack, there is a danger, he will pull all the senses inside. And when it is he is in safe zone, he keeps out. Okay, so similarly the senses of the Krishna conscious person are used only for some particular purpose in the service of the Lord and are withdrawn otherwise, like tortoise. When needed, senses are active. When not, no. So when he understands that here I have to serve Krishna, so he engages his senses in the service of Krishna. But when it is Maya, he keeps all the senses controlled like a tortoise. So that's the understanding here, that one Krishna conscious person should be like this tortoise. Okay, so Arjuna is being taught here to use his senses for the service of the Lord instead of for his own satisfaction. Okay, because here Arjuna is thinking that about his satisfaction, you know, if the people will be there, if he is thinking, if I fight I will get kingdom, then my relative will be there. So he is talking about his own satisfaction. So keeping the senses always in the service of the Lord is the example set by the analogy of the tortoise who keeps the senses within. So senses should be always engaged in the service of the Lord. All the senses can be engaged, like Maharaj Ambarish. Okay. Vishya vinirvartante niraharasya dehina rasavarjam raso apyasya param drashtva nivartate. Very important verse. So, though the embodied soul may be restricted from sense enjoyment, the taste for sense objects remains. Very important thing. So, first sloka 58 says that you control the senses. How long you will control? So, this says the solution. So, though the embodied soul may be restricted from sense enjoyment, sense objects remains. You can control, but the taste for sense object is still there. So, but seizing such engagements by experiencing a higher taste, he is fixed in consciousness. So, it is not only that you have to control the senses, but you have to engage your senses in the service of Krishna. So, what will happen? You will get a higher taste, because when you engage your senses in Maya service, in sense gratificatory activities, then you get some taste. And when you control them, okay, but the taste, you remember, so that taste will pull you towards that sense gratificatory item again and again. It will pull you back. Okay, there will be a strong urge again and again. So what you have to do? You have to engage yourself in the service of Krishna. So when you engage in the service of Krishna, you will get some higher taste. So this higher taste will make this lower taste as forgetful. So you can easily forget the lower taste because you are getting now higher taste. So you will get addicted to the higher taste, and then you will never be dragged towards the lower taste, which is sense gratification. So that is why many people who don't engage themselves in the service of Krishna, but they try to control the senses, many times they fall. They fall victim. They lose their control once. one day. So the solution is they have to engage themselves in the service of Krishna. So when they engage, they get higher taste. So the higher taste is very, very important. That higher taste will make you keep on going in bhakti, and very easily you will forget all the lower taste of sense gratification. That's the point. So Srila Prabhupada is saying that unless one is transcendentally situated, it is not possible to cease from sense enjoyment. Not possible. Unless one is transcendentally situated, it is not possible to cease from sense enjoyment. The process of restriction from sense enjoyment by rules and regulation is something like restricting a diseased person from certain types of eatables. What is that? The process of restriction from sense enjoyment by rules and regulation is something like restricting a diseased person from certain types of eatables. So many times people say, why Vedic system, why ISKCON people are restricting us from sense gratification? So it so many rules, regulation. Why? Because it is for our good. Like a diseased person, a person who is having some disease, a doctor says that don't eat these things. Like if you have a cough and cold, doctor will say that don't eat ice cream. Right? So that is, you say, oh, why so many rules, regulation? It is for your good. Right? So intelligent person understands the doctor is saying to me for this purpose, so he will follow the rules. Others will not follow. So the one who will follow the rule, he will get benefit. Otherwise, they will not get benefit. So the patient, however, neither likes such restriction nor loses his taste for eatables. Similarly, but there will be so many rules. So he, because he is forced and like that, he will not like the restriction. But anyway, because of restriction, he will not eat that particular item, ice cream. But still, he will not lose the taste for ice cream. So, similarly, sense restriction by some spiritual process like Ashtanga Yoga in the matter of Yama, Niyam, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahar, Dharan, Dharana, Dharana, Dhyan, etc. is recommended for less intelligent person. Wow. Prabhupada is saying that similarly, sense restriction by some spiritual process like Ashtanga Yoga in the matter of Yam, Niyam, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahar, Dharana, Dhyana, etc. is recommended for less intelligent persons who have no better knowledge. But one who has tasted the beauty of the Supreme Lord Krishna in the course of his advancement in Krishna consciousness no longer has a taste for dead material things. If a person gets taste for Krishna consciousness, taste of the Supreme Lord, the beauty of the Supreme Lord Krishna, then he will not get attracted towards any material thing. Therefore, restrictions are there for the less intelligent neophytes in spiritual advancement of life. But such restrictions are only good until one actually has a taste for Krishna consciousness. So these restrictions are very good till the point one don't get taste in Krishna consciousness. When one is actually Krishna conscious, he automatically loses his taste for pale things. So restrictions are there so that you don't take this item lower taste and you take higher taste. So more and more if you take higher taste, you will get that addiction. Addiction to Krishna consciousness. So once a person develops that taste for Krishna consciousness, this ruchi, then he automatically loses his taste for material things, for sense gratificatory items. Okay, so that's the point here. So how is the question is that how a Krishna conscious person restrains his senses and mentality. So what is the answer? He uses his senses only for Krishna's service. Based on higher taste, he can control his senses. So example is given, the analogy is given between tortoise and devotees. Tortoise implies to, this analogy implies that to keep senses always in the service of the Lord, withdraw when senses when not required. Always engage in the service of Krishna when it is not required, keep senses controlled. Okay, so a self-realized person can control his senses according to his plan whenever he wants, like a tortoise. And unless senses are controlled, a person should control his senses like a snake charmer. Okay, because senses are like a very dangerous snake. Okay, restraining is difficult because taste of sense object still remain. So analogy is given about a diseased patient. From some food item he is restricted, so he has to be, he whether he like or he don't like, he have to follow, and once he is cured, ultimately he will lose the taste. Okay, so patient will not like the restriction, but and still he will like the, he will have the taste for that food item, but anyway you have to follow, that is good for him. Okay, so this because of this only, because they are not engaged in any other higher taste, they are not given higher taste, so they will one day they will fall down. Okay, so the solution is that not only restrictions from the sense object, but also engagement in the higher taste of Krishna consciousness. Okay, then he will keep on going, progressing. So restrictions are only good in neophyte stage, but when person is advanced, when person has got taste in bhakti, when he got taste in chanting, when he got taste in hearing Krishna katha, automatically he will lose the taste in material thing, he will not have any taste. So there is no need of restriction anymore. That's the point here. Okay, so 2.60 will talk about next question, the fourth question, right? So then 2.64 till 671, the fourth question will come, like how does he walk. Okay, so 60 to 63, this section will explain how one who is not Krishna, not who is not in Krishna consciousness, may easily fall down. It implies the danger of Arjuna's plan to go to the forest to practice jnana and meditation, trying to avoid fighting and its apparent sinful reaction. So that will, this section will talk about the process of fall down. So this process of fall down tomorrow we shall discuss. Okay, Hare Krishna. Thank you so much. Shilpa Bhat ki jai. Granthra Ashwamedh Bhagavad Gita ki jai. Hare Krishna.